Hey guys, welcome or welcome back. If this is your first time here, my name is Katie. I am the owner and artist behind Salvaged by K. Scott. I make my living right here out of my garage at home, painting and restyling found and thrifted furniture pieces that are worn out or just plain outdated and bringing them right back to life. This week's furniture makeover project is yet another free dresser that I found at the side of the road.
This little six drawer solid maple dresser is a mid-century modern style made by a Canadian furniture company called Vilas. It has obviously already had a painted makeover, but it's a messy job and it is starting to chip off around the edges. So I am going to be stripping back all of this white paint and starting fresh. I have stripped a few other previously painted furniture pieces over the summer with this Super Remover paint stripper that I picked up at my local Canadian Tire store. And although I didn't have a great experience with it on the other pieces, I do still have some left. So I'm going to go ahead and apply a liberal coat to the top of the dresser and see what it does. This is a highly toxic and caustic product, so I made sure that I was wearing some chemical resistant gloves, as well as my respirator and some goggles in case of splashes. Once I had a good thick layer of stripper on the top of the dresser, I covered it in some plastic wrap to keep it from drying out while it made its chemical reaction. Now, I have never seen this particular stripper have an effect like this on a painted finish. I was so excited to see this reaction happen in about 10 minutes. And when I peeled back that plastic wrap, the paint lifted right up with it. I just used a metal paint scraper to scrape all of this goop off into a plastic bucket. Once I'm done with this process, I will make sure that I drop this off at my local hazardous materials waste site so they can properly dispose of it. Since the paint came off the top so very easily, I went ahead and did the same process on the drawers, the sides, and all of the front details of the dresser. I'm going to be totally honest with you here. Even though the paint came up easily, stripping paint off of furniture is messy, hard work. Once I was done with the stripper, I then had to go back with some mineral spirits and steel wool to scrub off any extra stripper residue and stop the chemical reaction. This is what the dresser looked like when I was done stripping. So now that I have all of the maple exposed, I think my plan for this piece is going to be a bare wood body for the dresser. I wasn't sure what I was going to do with the drawers at this point, but it was time to start sanding. I used my Surf Prep sander and one of their foam pads so that I could sand the round legs and curved details of these stretcher bars without flattening anything out. When it was time to start sanding the large flat areas like the top and sides of this dresser, I decided to switch out to my 5-inch random orbital sander simply because it's a little bit bigger than my Surf Prep is, so it's going to tackle these large flat areas a little faster. To remove what was left of the original finish and the stain on the wood, I started sanding with an 80 grit sandpaper. When you're working with a really coarse sandpaper like this, you want to let the machine do the work, make sure that you're moving it back and forth really slowly and in the direction of the wood grain. And of course, once I had the finish off of the top and sides, I needed to start working on these little details. For sanding these smaller areas, I switched back and forth between the random orbital and the 3x4 square sander, just depending on what fit in the space. I don't know whose idea this was, but I'm done. I quit. I'm not sanding those. I'm gonna scuff sand them to get the rest of the paint off, and then I'm repainting them. The body of the dresser. It's too much. It's too much work. I quit. I give up. I concede. So the 80 grit sandpaper that I used to remove the stained finish from the wood left me with a very rough feel. So I needed to go back with a 100 grit and then a 150 grit and finally a 220 grit sandpaper over the whole piece to make sure it was nice and buttery smooth. Since I wasn't able to fit either of my sanders up under the legs or under the stretcher bars, I decided I needed to take the entire leg system off of the dresser base so I could get into all of those nooks and crannies. Once I had the leg system off, I repeated the same process with all of my different sandpapers until everything was nice and clean. Now, because I had decided to paint the drawers, they didn't need to be sanded all the way down, but I did lightly sand off the rest of the paint and scuff up the surface. Again, since I'm going to be painting the drawers, I decided to prime them with my favorite Zinzerbin shellac-based primer. This will make sure that I have a nice cohesive base to paint on and that I won't have any wood tannins bleeding up through my new painted finish. I applied two quick coats of primer, and once it was dry, I sanded it smooth again to remove any roller bumps and then wiped back the sanding dust. And now that all the messy stuff is out of the way, I finally get to paint. I decided to paint the drawer fronts in House and Canvas chalk finish furniture paint in the color Summer Grace. I absolutely adore the way that this paint brushes, and with my little Zebra Palm Pro, I knew I could make quick work of these six drawer fronts without having to break out my sprayer. I got great coverage with this color in just two coats, and while my second coat was drying, I started to put the dresser back together and get it ready for top coat. To protect the wood that I spent so much time sanding down, and also the new painted drawer fronts, I'm going to be using a few coats of this Varathane Diamond Wood Finish in a satin sheen. And I'm gonna be applying this with a Country Chic paint sponge. I dampened my sponge with a little bit of water before I started, and then poured out some top coat into a separate container. Then I used my sponge to quickly wipe on a coat of this protective finish. Once again, I'm trying to stay going with the direction of the wood grain and not going back over what I've already laid down. I don't want to overwork this product. Once I was ready to move on to the drawer fronts, I rinsed out my sponge and poured out another dish of top coat so that I wasn't accidentally getting any wood tannins from the bare wood finish onto my painted surface. The first layer of top coat will cause the wood grain to raise, so I went back over everything with a super fine sandpaper to smooth it out and then applied an additional two coats. Okay, real talk here. I just put the drawers back in and I'm really not liking the pale pink with the orange undertones in the wood. And yeah, I don't like it. I definitely need to change it. So I'm gonna pull the drawers back out and paint them a different color. You can't get it right on the first time every time. Yeah, I even put the garage door up so that I could look at it in the natural light, and I don't like it. I mean, I like the pink and I like the wood. I just don't like them together. I took a few minutes to stare deeply into the soul of my paint collection and came up with the color Mud Puddle by Dixie Belle. And while this dresser turned out completely different than the original vision I had in my head when I had started painting pink, I do still really love the way it came together.
Even though this dresser was a ton of work, I am gonna go ahead and declare it a modern boho win. I'm so glad that I was able to save it from the side of the road and potentially ending up in the landfill. If you're not already subscribed to my channel and you love seeing what can happen with an old piece of furniture and a little bit of paint, please make sure that you are subscribed and have the notifications bell turned on so that you never miss a brand new video. And I will catch you guys next time. There's a world.